वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू ऑल माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, मायसेल्फ नितेश पटेल फ्रॉम लक्स स्कूल ऑफ साइंस, एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम एमसीक्यू रिलेटेड टू दैट इलेक्ट्रॉन गेन एंथैल्पी एज वेल एज द इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी, राइट। बट बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दैट, यू ऑल नो दैट व्हाट इज इलेक्ट्रॉन नेगेटिविटी एंड इलेक्ट्रॉन गेन एंथैल्पी। दैट इलेक्ट्रॉन गेन एंथैल्पी, दैट इज द एक्सोथर्मिक रिएक्शन इज देयर, so that it should be negative. So which one has a more electron gain enthalpy? So that we can say it's a chlorine. Then comes chlorine, then bromine, and then iodine that we have discussed. Then electronegativity, which one has a more electronegativity? There is a fluorine. Why? Because it has a more electron attracting capability, right? As compared to that of all other elements. So all these things we have discussed last time. Now, today let us start the MCQ. Which type of MCQs will be asked related to this topic? So let us see. The first MCQ will be given that here, write in the correct order of electron affinity or electron gain enthalpy. First, write the correct order of electron gain enthalpy. Please pay attention. Here the option will be given: A, fluorine, then comes chlorine, then comes bromine. B, fluorine, then chlorine, and then less than bromine. C, chlorine, and then bromine. And D, that is a fluorine, chlorine greater than bromine. Now see. Now, whenever I am going to find out the electron gain enthalpy, now you all know that which one has a more electron gain enthalpy, that is a chlorine. So it comes chlorine over here, then comes chlorine and then bromine. So the correct option is C, right? Second question, that here which of the following element has the highest electron for gain enthalpy, or you can say that which of the following element has the lowest value of electron gain enthalpy? Which of the following element has lowest electron gain enthalpy? Yes, which one? Here the option will be given: beryllium, chlorine, nitrogen, bromine, boron. Beryllium, chlorine, nitrogen, and boron. Now, as you all know, that whenever we are going to discuss about the electron gain enthalpy, then when we move from left to right, the electron gain enthalpy will become more negative, right? And here, beryllium, then comes boron, nitrogen, and then here comes chlorine, right? Here is a 3, here beryllium, boron, nitrogen. So when we move from left to right, the electron gain enthalpy will be increased and becomes more negative. Top to bottom it will be decreased. So which one has the lowest? So I can say beryllium, right? Is it clear? Now, next question. Next will be given: increasing order of electronegativity. Right? Increasing order of electronegativity. So here first option will be given, that first one, electronegativity, carbon, nitrogen, silicon, and phosphorus. B, nitrogen, silicon, carbon, and phosphorus. C, silicon, phosphorus, carbon, and nitrogen. And D, phosphorus, silicon, nitrogen, and carbon. Right? Now, here you have to find out the electrode negativity. As you all know that when we move from left to right, the electrode negativity will becomes more negative, that means increase, and top to bottom it will be decrease. So first of all you have to write down the element. The first came carbon, then nitrogen, silicon, and then phosphorus, right? This way. This is N equals to 2 and this is N equals to 3. Okay? Here this is 6, 7. Here 14 and 15. Right? When you move from left to right, the electronegativity will be increased. Top to bottom it will be decreased. So which one has the highest increasing order it will be given. So which one has the lowest electron negativity? To silicon, then came phosphorus, then came carbon, and then came nitrogen. See, so option will be C is the correct. Understand? So this is how you have to solve the MCQs, right? Note down. चलो नेक्स्ट. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन विल बी गिवन जस्ट लाइक नंबर 4. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग एलिमेंट इज मोर इलेक्ट्रो पॉजिटिव, राइट? ये दो ऑप्शन में भी गिवन, सोडियम, मैग्नीशियम, एल्युमिनियम एंड सिलिकॉन. सोडियम, मैग्नीशियम, एल्युमिनियम एंड सिलिकॉन. नाउ सी, नाउ हियर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द इलेक्ट्रो पॉजिटिविटी. नाउ यू ऑल नो दैट व्हेन वी मूव फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राइट द इलेक्ट्रो नेगेटिविटी विल बी इंक्रीज बट इलेक्ट्रो पॉजिटिविटी विल बी डिक्रीज. So group number 1 is a more electropositive element. So here you can say sodium that belongs to group number 1, that is the alkali metal, and that is more electropositive. Why? Because it has a tendency to donate the one electrons and becomes a positive charge. Okay, write down. Hello,
Charles. Maru particularly have principal side of the
So मैक्सिमम वैलेंसी इन ग्रुप इज बाय ग्रुप नंबर, मैक्सिमम वैलेंसी ऑफ ग्रुप इज इन ग्रुप नंबर डैश. Now this type of question will be asked. So here the maximum balance is 30, 14, 15, 16. Here first one 30, 14, 15, 16. Right? So which one has a maximum balance in group? Maximum balance of group in a group number. Here 13 balance name will be. Here 13 plus 3 plus 4, यहाँ पे plus 2, and so 14 group has a maximum balance, that is a plus 4. Here 15, that is a, we can also say that plus 3, and here plus 2, right? So 14 group number will have the maximum balance. Now here we have discussed about the different question which are going to ask in the JEE and NEET exam. Now the next topic that we are going to discuss, that is a oxide and hydride of what? That is a different groups and different periods, right? So which type of oxide and hydride it can be formed? What is the valency? Right? That you have to know. That what do you understand about the valency? The most important thing that you have to know, that is here the electron gain enthalpy. What do you understand about this electronegativity, then valency, right? What is the diagonal relationship is there? Now what is the diagonal relationship? That element which are present in the same group will have what? Same number of electrons in the outermost orbit. So that physical and the chemical properties are same. But some diagonal relationship will be there between the lithium and beryllium. Lithium, there is a similarity will be there between the group number 1 lithium and group number magnesium, beryllium and aluminium, right? So that also we are going to discuss. And then after we have also discussed that here let us suppose if we discuss about the diagonal relationship, then what is the relationship is there and how the relationship will be take place. Now if somebody asks the question that which one is a more metal, metallic characters. So metallic character means what? That when we move from left to right, we can say that the metallic characteristics will be decreased. And when we move from top to bottom, then the metallic characteristic will be increased. So which one is more metal? Right? So here sodium, then lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium and francium. Francium is a radioactive, so cesium is a more metal. And which one is a less metal? That is a fluorine. When we move from left to right, the metal characteristics will be decreased, and when we move from top to bottom, then the metal characteristics will be increased, right? And the most important thing that you have to remember, that in the S block element, all those elements are metal. In P block, metal is there, non-metal is there, and metalloid is there. And in D block element, we can say that all the elements are metal. That is the inner transition element is there. And F block, all are metal, but lanthanoid series, PM, that is a promethium, is a radioactive. Whereas in the actinoid series, all the elements which are present in the actinoid series, all the elements are said to be the radioactive. These things are the most important thing that you have to remember. Okay? So now one thing will be clear in your mind, that when we move from left to right, what happened? See, different trends are there. First one is the atomic radius, then ionic radius, then ionization enthalpy, then electron gain enthalpy, then electron negativity. All these things we have discussed in this chapter. So whatever the question will be asked, you should know how to solve that particular question. Okay? So in this video, up to this much enough. The next video we are going to discuss about the valency and hydride and oxide of different elements. Okay, so thank you very much. Now, periodicity of oxidation state and valency. Periodicity of oxidation state or valency, right? Now, the valence is the important properties of an element. We can say, first point, that the valence is an important properties of element, right? Okay, now let us suppose it can be easily understood by what? Electronic configuration of an element. It can be understood by, it can be easily understood by electronic configuration of an element. Electronic configuration of element. Right? Let us suppose the valence of representative element is usually equal to the number of electron in the outermost orbit. The valence of representative element is equal. Representative element, that means we can say it is a S block and P block element, right? Is equal to number of electron in the outermost orbit to the number of electron in the outermost orbit, right? As for example, it will be equal to the how many valence electron is there? 8 minus number of outermost electron. 8 minus number of outermost electron. Right? So that is the valency. I will give you some examples. Just like a, let us suppose here I can write down blue. Right? Okay? And then number of valence electron. I can write down number of valence electron. And here last one, there is a valence. Right? Group number 1, 2, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, and 80. Okay? Now, how many electrons is there in the outermost orbit? 1, yahan pe 2. 30 mein kitne electrons honge? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. These are the electrons which are present in the outermost orbit. Now, in valency, if you want to find out the valency, then yahan pe 1, 2, 3 aur yahan pe 4. Ab ye 5 jo hai na, to iski do valency aayegi, 3 and 5. Kyunki 8 minus 5, that is a 3. Yahan pe 2 and 6, yahan pe 1 and 7, aur yahan pe 0 and 8. Right? So all these are the valency. Jab 4 se jyada hoga na, तब 8 में से माइनस करो ये नंबर को, आउटरमोस्ट ऑर्बिट नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन, तो वैलेंस होगी 3 एंड 5, 2 एंड 6, 1 एंड 7 एंड 0 एंड 8. अंडरस्टैंड? इज इट क्लियर? वी कैन आल्सो से द वर्ड ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट इज आल्सो यूज्ड फॉर वैलेंस. ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट इज आल्सो यूज्ड फॉर वैलेंस. Okay, write down all these things. This is the valency, right? Okay, now let us consider the two elements which contain the oxygen. Let us consider two compound containing oxygen. Let us consider two compound containing oxygen. Which are they? One is OF2 and second is Na2O. Now, if I write down the electronegativity, order of electronegativity, order of electronegativity, इसकी इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी सबसे ज्यादा है तो फ्लोरीन, देन केम्स ऑक्सीजन एंड देन केम्स सोडियम. तो यहां पे फ्लोरीन नहीं गिरी तो ऑक्सीजन क्या आएगा? पॉजिटिव. इज इट क्लियर? नाउ आई गॉट द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिगरेशन. इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिगरेशन कॉन्फिगरेशन इसकी तो फ्लोरीन तो 9, ऑक्सीजन तो 8 और सोडियम देन 11. यहां पे 1s2, 2s2 and 2p5. 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. Right? The electronic combination. So fluorine has a tendency, it will share the one electrons and becomes a negative charge. Right? So we can say that the fluorine is more electronegative as compared to that of sodium and oxygen. Right? And that's why we can say that the oxidation state here in OF2, we can say that fluorine atom share one electron with oxygen atom. In OF2, fluorine atom share one electron with oxygen atom. यहां पर देखो ऑक्सीजन एटम से एक इलेक्ट्रॉन शेयर करता है. तो फ्लोरीन बीइंग मोर इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव एलिमेंट, फ्लोरीन बीइंग मोर इलेक्ट्रो नेगेटिव एलिमेंट, सो दैट ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट विल बी -1, राइट? एंड दैट्स व्हाई वी कैन से कंटेन -1 ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट व्हिच contain -1 oxidation state. Whereas oxygen is a less electronegative, so that's why the oxidation state of the oxygen. Whereas oxidation state of oxygen is +2. Understand? Why? Because it's a what? Less electronegative. Understand? Whereas in Na2O, oxygen atom is more electronegative. It shares the electron with the sodium atom. Right? Oxygen atom share how many electron? 2 electron with sodium atom. And so the oxidation element, oxygen is more electronegative element, so it contains -2 oxygen state. So oxidation state of oxygen is -2, right? Whereas sodium is +1. Sodium oxidation state of sodium is equal to +1. Right? Right? Because one electrons are present in the ES orbitals. So that's why we can say that there is some periodic trance is there. That is a, it is not fixed that the oxidation state of oxygen should be -2. It is a depend upon the compound. यहाँ पे देखो कि यहाँ पे oxygen का oxidation state क्या था? तो ऑक्सीजन का ऑक्सीजन स्टेट +2 था. यहां पे Na2O में कौन सा आया? Na2O में ऑक्सीजन का ऑक्सीजन स्टेट क्या आया? -2. और OF2 में ऑक्सीजन का ऑक्सीजन स्टेट क्या आया? तो +2, राइट? So this means you have to remember that that is a depend upon the which element it will be shared the electron, right? अगर ये ऑक्सीजन के सोडियम से इलेक्ट्रॉन शेयरिंग करता है तो ये क्या करेगा कि इट हैज अ टेंडेंसी टू व्हाट, यहां पे क्या होगा कि इट हैज अ टेंडेंसी टू डोनेट द इलेक्ट्रॉन और यहां पे क्या होगा कि इट हैज अ टेंडेंसी टू गेन द इलेक्ट्रॉन, राइट? व्हाई? बिकॉज़ क्लोरीन इज मोर इलेक्ट्रो नेगेटिव. यहां पे कौन इलेक्ट्रो नेगेटिव ज्यादा है? तो ऑक्सीजन. जिस कंपाउंड में जिस एलिमेंट की इलेक्ट्रो नेगेटिविटी ज्यादा है वो नेगेटिव ऑक्सीजन स्टेट उसका आएगा और जिसकी कम है उसका ऑक्सीजन स्टेट क्या आएगा? Positive, right? So these things you have to know. Okay. So to here, thank you. Thank you very much. In the next video, we are discussing about the hydride and oxide. Okay.